I've been particularly touched by Asian American men who come up to me and tell me that when they were growing up in Northern Florida or in New Jersey or in Minnesota, that they were the only Asian boy in their community, in their class, and the image that they usually saw of Asians on television and movies were pretty unattractive ones. I was the only one that gave them a sense of pride, a sense of wanting to connect with someone on the media. And whenever there was game playing, they got to be Sulu. And they now here they are as young junior executives or young professionals, and they would come up to me dressed in their suit and tie and tell me how important I was to their early years and during their formative years. And for me as an individual, it's very gratifying that I was able to make that contribution.
When this thing came along, it was my first crack at a long-running job, at a job that had potential to run longer than 2 weeks. And I had a family and to support, and I had been working at a lot of other work to support that family outside of acting. I'd done some teaching. I also drove some taxis for a while.
When I went over to see about this, I signed for 7 out of 13. And I thought, that's 7 weeks work. 7 solid weeks of work, and I'll go back and maybe move on to the motion picture. I was really trying to establish myself in motion pictures. But that 7 weeks turned out to be the end of the line, so to speak. That was it.
I didn't read for something called Uhura because she wasn't cast. It wasn't cast and it wasn't written. So I read for somebody called Spock.
So they were looking for somebody who would draw the same kind of audience that the monkeys drew. And I guess I fit the bill. So it's a hell of a reason to be cast on in a role that eventually became part of my life for 30 years.
And I kept asking them, well, tell me about Spock. What is she like? And they kept looking at each other, and they said, don't you know anything about the show? And I said, no, I've been in Europe for 6 months. And they said, well, Spock is not female. Spock is male. Also, he's not of Earth. He's from another planet. And I said, he's what? Came out, he's got green blood and pointed ears. I said, how do I read for that?
Agent called and he said, he's got an interview for me. I thought, fantastic. He said, it's a science fiction project. I thought, mm-hmm. And then he said, it's being produced by a man named Gene Roddenberry. I thought, who is he? Number three, he said, it's a pilot for a potential series. And that's when my ears perked up, because it meant, if it sells, steady employment.
They let me suffer for about 2 more hours before they said, come on, I'll take you to lunch. You got the part, you had it when you walked in. It was great reading.
The character's name was Captain Koloth in The Trouble with Tribbles. And he was what it describes. He was the captain of the Klingons, and he was the counterpart to Captain Kirk. And of course, they knew each other.
Ah, my dear Captain Kirk.
My dear Captain Koloth.
A little aside is that Gene Roddenberry and I and Mr. Kuhn had a 13-episode verbal agreement that I would do Koloth in subsequent shows.
We Klingons are not as luxury-minded as you Earthers. We do not equip our ships with, how shall I say it, non-essentials.
Because Mr. Roddenberry had gotten to the point where he, he thought it was about time to have an adversary for Kirk that would be kind of running, not every show, but 13 in the course of the year. But he dropped the show before we ever had an opportunity for that. But that was a marvelous part.
I expect you to assume full responsibility for the persecution of Klingon nationals in this quadrant.
It wasn't a long role, but it was a very good part. And I regret that it couldn't have gone on, because I remember Gene Roddenberry saying to me, and Gene Kuhn, how do you see yourself vis-a-vis Captain Kirk? I said, well, I see him. I have a great deal of respect for him. And the strange thing is, I will protect him from anybody harming him, because if anybody's going to kill Captain Kirk, it's going to be me.
Captain Kirk, our relationship will be a peaceful one.
Let us both take steps to keep it that way.